we are left with gamma 2 and gamma 3. Gamma 2 and minus half plus half, while gamma 3 is here and gamma 3 is minus half plus half. Clear? And here we are left only with delta 1, which is plus half plus half. Is this clear? So what we minimize the number of non-zero terms. So only the non-zero terms are here. Now we will have to find these terms. And in order to find these terms, we are having some restrictions. And the restrictions are that if I multiply the inner product of 0,0 state with 0,0 state, what it will be equal to? These coupled states are orthonormal states. So it will be equal to 1. 0 with 0, state with itself. This is the one that you have studied. Psi m with psi m. This is equal to delta mn, the Kronecker delta. If m will be equal to n, you will get 1. If m will not be equal to n, you will get 0. Here these states are the same states, so these will be equal to 1. Similarly, from here we will get 0,0 state. Now they are not involving any iota. So it means it will be the product of this with this. While when these states will multiply, they will give 1. Clear? This is the ket notation, the bra notation of that one. When you change them, if they are matrices, you will take transpose and conjugate. If they are just functions like this, you will just take their conjugate. So here, if I multiply means this with the kept with the bra notation of this. So what will happen? This will become the conjugate of this multiplied with this. It will become, this is in the kit notation, it will become the bra wedge. So it, when this matrix will multiply with this, it will give you 1. When this will multiply with itself, it will give you 1. When this will multiply with this, you will get 0. Clear? Because these are orthonormal states. So what I will get here, I will get that alpha 2 is there. So alpha 2 conjugate with alpha 2 plus alpha 3 conjugate with alpha 3, while the matrices will come out to be 1. These will come out to be 1. So what I will get, that alpha 2 square plus alpha 3 square is equal to 1. This is our one equation. Clear? Similarly, if I do multiply now the next one, the 1, 1. So 1 minus 1, and I take the inner product with 1 minus 1. What you will get? Only one term. So it will be beta 4 conjugate into beta 4. While this will multiply with the bra of it, then it will come out to be 1. So I will get that beta 4 mod square are simply square because no iota is involved is equal to 1. Clear? So beta 4 is equal to 1. And similarly, what about 1,0? 1,0 and 1,0. So 1,0 is here. we will get gamma 2 square plus gamma 3 square equal to 1, just like this one. Gamma 2 square plus gamma 3 square is equal to 1. While for this state, 1, 1, 1, 1, and 1, 1. This implies only one term is here. So we will have delta 1 square is equal to 1. Now these two are very easy. Here, beta 4 is equal to 1. So this implies that beta 4 is equal to 1. While here, delta 1 square is equal to 1. So it means delta 1 is equal to 1. The problem is with this one. Clear? The problem is with alpha and with gamma. We also know one thing, that if I do multiply any of these states with one another, like I take the multiplication of 1, 0 with 0, 0, means any two states I do multiply, 0, 0 with 1, 0 for example, these are orthonormal. So what we will get?
0.
We will get 0. So it means, if I multiply gamma 2 with alpha 2, gamma 2 with alpha 2, then gamma 3 with alpha 3, inner product, so only the respective components will multiply. These are for 1, 0. 1, 0 means that these will come first. So it means that gamma 2 conjugate will multiply with alpha 2 plus gamma 3 conjugate will multiply with alpha 3 and you will get 0 as a result. We will have to calculate that what are the values of alpha 2 and alpha 3, because beta and delta we have calculated. Only two values are remaining, alpha 2 and alpha 3, and gamma 2 and gamma 3. Now we know the fact, that you remember when S square was operating on any wave function, okay? S square when operates on any wave function, then it was giving S into S plus 1 and that wave function with h bar square, Now when I will apply S square on such a combination, like for example 1 and 1 for example, S square on 1 and 1, then what it will be? S is equal to 1 here. So I will have 1 into 1 plus 1. Means of this state I don't need to write h bar square. So 1 and 1, and this is equal to this state again, and I will have 2 in this state. Now, as you remember, we have written J for this S. So J square on one state will be, on one state with this one, and on 1, 0 state, because J is equal to 1 here, it will be J into J plus 1. So it will be equal to 2 times 1, 0 state. Similarly, when J square will apply on 0, 0 state, so S is 0 here, J is 0 here, so it will be equal to 0. Clear? We have already proved this thing. This is our direct result that we have done much earlier. Now I will apply J square on the product state. So when I do apply J square on a product state, so I will convert the J square into the individual forms, like the later operators, J plus N, J minus. One thing I will do this, that the J square I will convert into J plus N, J minus. The next thing that I will do is, if you remember that we were doing, when it was S square, we were writing S1 square and S2 square. S1 was operating on electron, S2 was operating on proton spin. So the 1 and 2 are actually the two different particles. So we will not only split this into its individual J plus J minus, but also J1 and J2. So I can write that J square is equal to J1 square, J1 square plus J2 square, J1 square plus J2 square plus two times J1 dot J2. Clear? J square, J1 square plus J2 square plus 2 times J1, J2. Because J is a combination of J1 plus J2 whole squared. And this is equal to this. Right? Now, this form, J1 dot J2, what I will do with this? This is the inner product, J1. Now J1, this I can split like this. This will be J1 plus J2 plus J1 minus and J2 plus. J1 minus J2 plus 2 times J1Z and J2, the Z components. If you remember, we have done the same thing with the orbital angular momentum. When we were writing in the form of S plus minus, L plus minus, you remember? When we were writing the later operators for L plus minus, then we were having the L1, L2, and then at the end we were having Lz involved there. And look big and you will get this relation. So I can write that if I apply J1 square, J square, so this one, this step is crucial. J squared on 1, 0. Then what I will write for J square? For J square I will write J1 square plus J2 square plus J1 plus J1, J2, Lz is there. This one is here is 1 minus and 2 plus. We will write this the opposite, 1 plus 2 minus. J1, J2 means we have split them in their individual operators. Like J1 plus will only interact with the 1 state. And J2 will interact with the second state only. Mean J2 cannot interact with the one state. So this is J1 plus J2 minus. Right? J1 plus, and remove this plus symbol. This plus is here. J1 plus into J2 minus, then J1 minus into J2 plus 2 times J1 C in J2 C, the C components. So this will be equal J1 square J2 square plus J1 plus J2 minus plus J1 minus J2 plus, okay, means don't merge these plus with these plus, these are just the notations, and here this is the addition, plus 2 times J1 Z component and J2 Z component, and this will apply on the state 1, 0. And what is 1, 0 with us? 1, 0 is this state, 1, 0. And the remaining parts are gamma 2 and gamma 3. So this is gamma 2, and the state is minus half plus half plus gamma 3. Okay, we are giving, now we have done so mistake, minus half, yes. This one is plus half and this is minus half. So we are giving plus half here and minus half here. Plus gamma 3, and we are having minus half and plus half. Clear? And our bracket is closed here. And now do apply all this. This is equal to, first, apply J1 square on this one, gamma 2 only. Then J2 square on gamma 2. Then J1 plus and J2 minus on this. And J1 minus and J2 plus on this. And then the last term on this. Then we will apply J1 square on gamma 3 and then the next term and the next term and the next term. Right? So first, apply J1 square on this, what you will get? Gamma 2 will be here because it's the coefficient. When J1 square applies on a state, what you get? Yes?